Dear friends, in today's video tutorial, I will discuss the PWM power supply problem of LED TVs and its solution. So, watch the video carefully until the end, then you will learn something new. So, let's get started. This is the TV's bright core power transformer. There are two coils in the secondary section. The common tap of two coils is connected to the ground. This terminal is connected to the anode of this diode, and this terminal is connected to the anode of this diode. From the cathode of this diode, 12 volts is output for the TV's operating voltage. And from the cathode of this diode, 27 volts is output for the backlight driver circuit. So, let's measure if there are 27 volts here. There is only 0.08 volts. In this situation, we need to measure the DC input voltage. DC 318 volts. So, there is no problem with the DC input here, but from the secondary, 27 volts and 12 volts are not being output. Now, let's try to understand why the power output problem occurs. It is the power transformer. As a switching device, it is an N-channel MOSFET. The drain terminal of this MOSFET is connected to the primary coil of the SMPS transformer. From the positive terminal of this filter capacitor, a positive supply is provided to this coil to bias the drain of the MOSFET. And from the negative terminal, the ground connection goes to the source terminal of the MOSFET. And 12 volts and 27 volts are output from the secondary coils when AC is input to the gate terminal of the MOSFET. So, we need to know how AC is generated in this DC circuit. Here is a high performance PWM controller. It looks like an ant, but its actions are like an elephant's. Inside this PWM IC, many circuits are integrated to produce smooth and safe DC voltage output. Okay, now to solve the power problem, let's follow the circuit diagram of this PWM IC. The link is in the video description. Here is its circuit diagram. From IC pin 6, the PWM signal goes to the gate of the MOSFET. And at IC pin 5, VDD or operating voltage is input from the main filter capacitor by this resistor. So, to solve the power problem, we need to measure the VDD voltage at IC pin 5. So, let's measure the voltage at pin 5. 0.48 volts, but here it will be more than 12 volts. So, look carefully. At IC pin 5, VDD supply is coming through this 2 series resistor from the capacitor. But we measured there is no voltage here. So, let's measure the voltage here. There are 315 volts here and here 150 volts. But the VDD pin of the IC has only 0.7 volts. So, this resistor must have been damaged. So, let's connect a 1 mega ohms resistor here. Okay, now let's measure the output voltage. 27 volts.